Welcome to another episode.
Welcome back to another episode of Sick Gear. Today we're talking about allergy masks and which ones you should choose if you have severe immune problems and allergies and asthma like me. My name is Jeffrey Lin. On my channel, I document my journey with three severe chronic illnesses and the tips and tricks I've learned over the years. So in this video, I'll talk about why I use my signature industrial grade mask instead of the Vogmask that's pretty popular right now, and the background and the details so you can make the best choice, because again, not everybody have the same symptoms and not everybody is reacting to the same things. But before we begin, remember to subscribe. If you don't subscribe, this video will just stop right here. I'm just kidding. Roll the intro.
Hit it!
That's what I'm talking about.
Wait!
Okay, now, from the beginning.
Hit it, boy.
Just bring normal fellas.
Aside from the severe eczema that I talk about all the time, I also have one of the most severe allergy immune reactions to literally everything on the planet, which will cause severe asthma attack, as well as my body flaring up internally inside my brain. My skin will start leaking within minutes. That's just how intense it gets. Even when I'm inside a car with only inside air, if there's a seafood restaurant a mile away, I'll react to it and I'll start going into anaphylactic shock. Growing up with this condition, I never had a good protection against environmental triggers. And it's not just the regular dust or even germs. It's, again, food odors in the air, you know, perfume, animals, even marijuana. A lot of people say marijuana is great for them, and I believe them, but for me, it's another allergic trigger. Growing up, we only had like these kind of doctor, dentist kind of masks, and these will block out some, but it's not going to help protect me from stuff like this, which is, you know, every year in California, we get these massive, massive fires where it's not just wood and houses that are burning, but it's all the electronics, it's all the paint and the chemicals. So there's a lot of stuff in the air that would trigger someone like me to have an allergic reaction. I even react to weather that's a week away. And a lot of these symptoms are similar to the MCAS, or mast cell activation syndrome. So those of you who have MCAS would relate. Also, if you have asthma like me, wearing a mask has the added benefit of keeping out the cold air and keeping the air moist, because the mask kind of seals in the moisture from your lungs that you exhale. So instead of using a humidifier that's trying to add moisture to this big room, which is kind of hard to do, a mask can just seal in all the moisture from your breathing, and it'll make it a lot easier for your lungs to function. This kind of stuff is what doctors and nurses usually wear, and these don't really help. What should you get? So I had to start digging somewhere else. I looked into the CDC, which is the Center for Disease Control, which manages all the outbreaks and infections across the country. So on the CDC website, they categorize respirators with three different letters, which you'll find on all these breathing masks and respirators. The first is the letter N, which is non-oil resistant. R, which is resistant, but it just means somewhat resistant. You have to throw it away after you use it once. There's a letter P, which means it's oil proof, which means it's very strongly resistant to oil and you can reuse it over and over. So level P is the strongest and it covers everything. The second part of the rating is a number, which is usually 95, 99, or 100. So 95 just means the breathing mask or the respirator will filter out 95% of particles and things it's supposed to block. 99 means it's supposed to block out 99% of things it's supposed to block. And 100 means it'll block out 99.97% of particles and germs and bacteria out there that it's supposed to block. So obviously the 100 rating is the best. And I know it only says 99.97. That's as good as it can get. It's just like the HEPA filters that we talked about. The HEPA filter, which catches 99.97 of anything that's out there, including bacteria, viruses, dust. Medically speaking, usually a mask or a respirator with the letter N is good enough for being in hospitals to protect you from germs and viruses and bacteria. But the masks with the N ratings don't block out vapors or gases, so there are chemicals and other types of gases that the N ratings won't protect you from. So that's why we go with the P rating filters. All right, so which kind of mask should you use? This kind of mask is very popular right now, and the biggest brand is the Vogmask, so this is what people usually call it. The rating on this is N99, so again, N just means it'll capture all particles, including dust and smoke, even bacteria and viruses, but it will not get the vapors and the gases and certain chemicals in the air. So if you only react to smoke and dust, this will be good enough for regular pollution. But to have an extra layer of protection, I don't think any N-rated masks will be enough. It just really depends on how reactive your body is to the environment and what you react to. And Vogue masks also won't protect you from the volatile organic compounds that we talked about before. Can we roll the air purifier video? VOCs, or volatile organic gases. And they're very common, especially in the household. They're found in furniture and cleaning supplies, paint, and even carpets. VOCs can cause skin and respiratory irritation, allergies, and headaches. I have a Aware air monitor right here that monitors several things, including volatile organic gases, which is this fourth indicator right here. It's showing one dot, which is low level, so it's safe. VOCs are typically not acutely toxic. That means they're not going to cause you to react or even be aware that they're around, but they have long-term slow effects that they just build up in your body, and eventually they'll cause a lot of trouble for you, or it might just give you like permanent headaches, or you can't think, or you're just fatigued. A lot of it could be because of VOCs. I always go with the P100 ratings, which is what these filters are for these masks, and even for this disposable one. So the oil-based particles that the P100 rating mask protects us from are things like aerosols, which is in spray paint and anything you spray, solvents, pesticides, and even stuff like nail polish, anything you can kind of smell the fumes, irritates your eyes, those kind of things. The P100 will protect you from that. Quick rundown of the P100 respirators that I use. This one is the light disposable one, and I usually keep this in my backpack as a backup, and I'll use this at home. And the second one I have uses my standard face piece from 3M. These are disposable, so these can come off and interchange with the bigger filters that I have. Again, these are P100 rated filters, but they're thinner, so they don't last as long, and you gotta just remember to change these more. So I also just wear these at home, so if I have to wear it for a longer period of time, it won't strain on my neck too much. All right, here's the one you guys see me wear all the time. It's the same face piece from 3M, but it has a long-lasting filter like this. It's pretty thick, has vents on both sides, and these last for a couple months at a time. They do have an expiration date. The specific model is the number 60923, and 3M has several of these P100 filters, and the difference is they protect you against different kinds of organic chemicals like I was talking about. This is the one that I found that works best for me. Some of you eczema sufferers like me have asked if a material like this, which is, I guess it's a type of neoprene, if this will irritate the skin. So far it's worked fine for me, and I think it'll be fine if your eczema is the dry kind. This kind of material is only bad if you have the wet kind of eczema that I had several years ago, and you're already leaking, so this kind of material won't be very absorbent and it'll just let that infection fester. So, but if you have the dry eczema, I think this will be just fine. All right, guys, that's it. Hope you have a better understanding of which breathing mask or respirator you should choose that will work best for you. And if you are reacting to things like I am, even when you're wearing like the N95 or like the N99 Vogmask, then, you know, try to upgrade to the P ratings and go for the P100s and see how you feel. You should feel a ton better. It'll save you a ton of money on buying medications. And for me, it's opened up my world because with this guy right here, I've been able to travel all over the world to places where even I have no clue what kind of odors and smoke and fragrances and pollutions there be there. But because the P100 rating blocks literally everything on the planet, I feel safe going anywhere with this guy. If you guys have any questions, leave a comment below. Also tell me which one's working for you. And please subscribe, tell your friends about this video. It'll help me a lot. And my goal is so that I can reach more people that have chronic illnesses and help them out.